How can you tell if an Xbox One controller has built-in Bluetooth? Let's find out. Hey everybody, I asked that previous question because I recently uploaded a video about a newer Xbox One controller that I bought sometime last week. The main reason why I bought that controller is because I want to connect it to an 8-bit do. It's a little USB dongle that has a built-in Bluetooth receiver, and it practically makes any controller that has built-in Bluetooth usable on a Nintendo Switch. And my main point is I want to use an Xbox controller with this thing, but the problem is I need to know if my controllers have Bluetooth or not. So thanks to Google and one quick search, any person can become an instant genius and know everything about everything. But with that Google search, the first result was the Xbox support page, and it straight up tells you the difference on that page between a Bluetooth and non-Bluetooth Xbox controller. On Bluetooth supported controllers, the plastic around the Xbox button is part of the face of the controller. On controllers without Bluetooth, the plastic around the Xbox button is part of the top where the bumpers are. And they included a little diagram and everything because, you know, some people are visual learners. So let's take a look at some of my Xbox controllers so that we can spot the difference and know which ones have Bluetooth and which ones don't.
All right. So I picked up the first model Xbox One back around holiday time 2013, so around the first few months it first came out. And the pack and controller for that model does not have Bluetooth. I believe Bluetooth on the controller was first introduced when the Xbox One S came out in 2016. So essentially any controller released after that has Bluetooth built in. It's a bit hard when trying to differentiate the controllers though, especially when they're both black. But it's clear that the 2013 pack and controller has a shinier area around the top where the Xbox button is, or the Xbox home button is. It's clear that the plastic around the button is part of the bumpers. You can see it all becomes one little unit right there at the top. You can actually see that the top portion of the controller has a really big groove. Everything's kind of set in right there where the bumpers and the Xbox One button is. So with this other controller, I actually got this one as a pack-in with the Xbox One X that I bought from Wish. So this is a way newer controller. So around the area where the Xbox button is, it's the same matte finish as the whole entire controller. So you can see it's just one big continuous shell. And also the grooves are much more shallow in comparison to the first packing controller from 2013. So these newer controllers have a more shallow groove right there, and you can clearly tell that it's all part of the face. So it's a bit difficult trying to tell the difference between the black controllers, but with colored controllers it's way easier to see the difference. I bought this Lunar White controller September 2015 when it was first released, so the only difference is they added a headset jack in the bottom, so you don't have to use a proprietary. But there's a dead giveaway that there's no Bluetooth. That whole black top portion where the Xbox button is, it's all connected to the bumpers. All of these older controllers will have that same black strip or something really similar, or you can tell that the Xbox button is connected to the bumpers. Comparison, the blue and gray controller that I bought recently has the same gray finish throughout the whole entire front of the controller, and the plastic around the Xbox button is part of the face. It's clearly a part of the face, so it's easier to tell the difference between these colored controllers, and that groove once again is much more shallow. That's pretty much it though. Aside from knowing the model number or the date of release of the controller, those are the only traits that kind of help differentiate the difference between a Bluetooth and non-Bluetooth Xbox One controller. So I hope this video helps some of you out there. I know that it helped me, or at least educated me a little bit, especially because I plan to connect that blue and gray Xbox controller to an 8-bit do, so that video will be out sometime this week. So make sure to subscribe and click that notification bell if you're interested in checking that content out. But you made it this far, you stuck it through with me, so why not check out these other videos? Or not. Regardless, I hope everybody has a great day. New videos coming soon. I'll talk to everybody soon. Bye bye.